Hi everybody and welcome to the channel, I am Richard. Today I'm going to be speaking to you about a passion of mine. I mean, it's no secret that I love board games and I love miniatures, but I also really love terrain pieces. I love the look of these things on the table. I love the feeling of them when the miniatures runs around them. I just love how they enhance your game and takes it to just another level. It's beautiful. And besides this, I also love the gaming mats, as these also just help to give you just another level in the gaming experience itself. These specific pieces I'm going to be speaking about today come from Gamemat.eu. These guys, they have everything you need to raise your miniature game. They have terrain pieces, they have foldable gaming tables, they have gaming mats, and they even have some games as well. And these specific pieces here, they come pre-painted, which just saves you so much time. I mean, you could paint this and it wouldn't take that much time, but it would still take you a couple of hours to prime it all and paint it. And if you really like to, you could also paint this as well in your own color if you really would like to do that, but you can just pick this up out of the box and start playing with it right away. So let me show you all the pieces. What I have here is two game mats from Gamemats.eu, but it's really three game mats because one of them is double-sided. So on one side you have the city area with the roads, the industrial area, the building area, and on the other side you have the wasteland area. And my wife just loves this one because it does not take up that much space in the house. So instead of having two different mats, I have two mats on one, which saves a lot of space. The other one I have here is the space mat. This one is single-sided, so on the other side you can see the rubber material that it's printed on. And this is like a mouse pad material. It's quite sturdy. I mean, you can't rip this apart even if you try. And I would even let my kids play with this if they wanted to. Because if you spill on it, it's really no worries. You can just wipe it right off and it will be just as beautiful again. A plus side by using these mats is also if you use cards, they won't slip around like they do on a normal table. I mean, if you sleeve your cards and you put them on a table, we all been there, they slide away from you. Also, when you're going to pick up the cards again, you almost have to tear the table apart to get the damn card up. But on this one, it just flows naturally and you can just pick it up without having to lose any hair. I wish I had figured that one out a lot sooner. This is the Ghotic set from Gamemat.eu, and you get 9 pieces of buildings because they're all blown into pieces. But that's just the way it should be in a miniature game. I mean, you can't get a whole house in a sci-fi miniature game. And these ones all come in different sizes. You have the smaller ones, where you can hide in the corner and you can put your little men up here as snipers. And then you have the medium-sized ones that you also have. You have the windows and you have the really beautiful brickwork there with the small details. It looks just so beautiful. And then we have the medium size here, the little bit bigger sized buildings. And these ones are resin printed. They're a bit sturdy, they're actually quite heavy. There's a lot of weight to this one, but you should be careful with this. This I wouldn't let my children play with because they might just break it. But I think it's really looking beautiful. And besides these ones, you also get one quite large one here with the blown up floor. You have the beautiful Gothic windows where you can put your snipers in here. And these windows down here, you can actually block them out. The same thing with the bigger windows or doors down here. You can block them out as well. I'm going to show you that a little bit later in this video. But you get 9 pieces of the building sets. Besides that, you also get 5 smaller walls that you can put out a little bit everywhere on your terrain. Just to give the whole area a little bit more life. Just put it together in a better way. Also a lot of beautiful work on this one. Like I said, this comes pre-painted. So this is straight out the box. I've done nothing to them. I just opened the box and I showed them to you on this video. and it saves you a lot of time. I mean, miniature gaming takes a lot of time. You have to paint the miniatures, you have to learn the rules, you have to actually find time to play the game. So if you can save time, well, do it. I mean, especially if you have kids and families and everything. I need to save time. I'm doing these videos, I'm doing the board gaming, I'm doing the miniature gaming. Pre-painted things is just a big plus, at least for me. So I wanted to show you what I meant about blocking out some of the windows. Because if you're putting up a gaming area, you might not want all of this line of sight. You might want to block some of these out. That's why you get these pieces included in the box. As you can see here, they are compatible with some of the windows, which lets you block out line of sight. So for example, if you don't want this window to be open, you can put the piece in and it's closed. The same thing over here, you just put it in and all of a sudden it is a blocked wall instead. Brilliant! I wanted to show you everything you get in the box from the Ghotic set. So this is the Ghotic set on top of a Wasteland gaming mat from Gamemat.eu. And I just wanted to show you the whole set on the mat so you could get an idea of how big of a gaming area you actually can do of this. You have the line of sight, but you also have a lot of protection between behind the small walls. You have some beautiful stonework here on everything. You could probably paint this yourself if you really wanted to. I'm not gonna paint this. I'm just gonna leave it just the way it is. You have the Ghotic windows. These are the ones that you could block out. Beautiful stonework. And then you also have the little tower over here. And these are the pieces I showed you before that you use to block out some of the windows. You get four of the big ones and three of the small ones. Now we have a little platform your warriors can stand on. Some more stonework. And here they can hide in the small areas down here as well. And with this set you can really bring your hometown to life. I don't even think you would need everything in it to make this, but looks cool, right? I also just wanted to give you a closer look on the city map here. You have the broken roads and the old building department areas where you can build up your walls and you can build up your little city here. And you have the different areas here where you can put up walls and you can do one industrial area here and another room over here. Maybe this is an old factory. And it's really well made. You have all the little cracks here in the concrete that makes it look really old, really tear down. You even have some garbage there, the old parking spots. And of course, blood on the floor. And when you're done with the gaming, you just roll up that gaming mat and put them in this nifty little bag. And remember, I have two gaming mats in here and it basically takes no space at all because they were double-sided, so it saves me a lot of space. The terrain, on the other hand, is going to take some space. You can't fold it up. You really can't put it down in a little box. You need a big box. Or a big shelf in the middle of the living room to show off this beautiful terrain. Your wife is gonna love that. Kind of. Anyway, if you like this video, please hit thumbs up, give me a press on the subscribe button, and I see you next week.